Cooking in the Pantheon, the, of course, post six roam potential after he dominates lane. That's something we're going to be looking towards. But the CC alongside Gragas, 2v2 mid is key.
But thinking about the circles, Raz, think about the
circles.
Yeah, they're looking for this. Doinby making his way down. Remember, he now has the reset on that passive. He can tank turret so incredibly effectively. Great flash to get Viper out of the way. There is all the respect here from Griffin.
And it's nice to see this side from the LPL teams. The sort of stuff
going to be very useful here for Griffin as Flawless Duet doesn't land. The man drop is coming in. The dragon is stolen. But now the fight may also go the same way. The Pantheon grabs the first blood. Viper is well and truly dead. And the LPL in game number three have
certainly does seem to be the FPX game plan, and it's not changing, but is there anything Griffin can actually do about it?
Well, this is FPX's red side jungle. They've been there since level one. They own this, even though it should be Griffin's, right, based on map geography. So well, hard to play against this Pantheon.
The man drop coming in once again. Tarzan able to get out of the way, but Doinby so far forward. The cask is good, and that is two real easy kills, and they're both on the Pantheon.
Or five-man wipe, and then I agree.
Okay.
Well, there's the other man drop. Viper going to take a hell of a lot of damage here. We're holding onto the Devourer for as long as possible. Lahens finally pops it and goes golden. Chovy is going to turn up underneath this turret now as everyone FPX is so down.
No way.
Griffin have found it. See you later, mate. That is so much money.
This early game lead is something that they needed.
Oh.
Okay, we're going to check this out as Chris.
Oh.
Yeah, he died.
LWX now in a 1v1, he doesn't want it. All four of the Drakes have gone to FPX, but now the fight is gonna break out. Vanguard's Edge goes completely wide, as now it's FPX trying to get out. Doinby is gonna get stunned. That Flawless Duet was exactly that. The Blast Cone as well was fantastic, but Griffin are trying to escape. Tian so fast as Chovy is gonna be put into the death chamber after that one. It's a decent little stopwatch, but not enough to get any joy. This is going to turn up. No smite from that unsealed spell. Look at Tarzan!
Yes.
Dives in, but doesn't take the Baron. And Raz, the LPL fan, the colors are showing there as they dive into the pit. But the 50-50 is one from
pesky little siege minion is doing some work. Sword makes his way back, but the ultimate goes wide and the turret is going
committing
to fall. The cask is fantastic. Goodbye, Aatrox, as now the man drop comes forward, but it's all for zoning and the inhibitor will go down 26 minutes into the game. FPX,
they're
right back in the driver's seat.
Yep.
And I'm mincing my words because I wasn't expecting it. Griffin looked so strong. Moving quickly.
Really?
As the ultimate once again going to go wide. Oh, they still go in. LWX not even going low just yet as the Guardian Angel is popped so quickly. And FPX are just too far ahead. They've got too much damage and they will be keeping the LPL alive in this best of five.
Blown away. And you have to believe with the death timers that you
they're the ones that come up smiling, and we will be going to a game number four after this last bit of action happens.
Yeah, the way they were able to recalibrate after losing that dive under that inner turret, it was Doinby changing that playstyle and handing over the